गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट डीएनए। इन द स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द चैप्टर वी डिस्कस दैट डीएनए इज द जेनेटिक मटेरियल। इन मोस्ट ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिजम्स इट्स डीएनए एंड इन फ्यू ऑफ द वायरसेस इट इज आरएनए व्हिच इज एक्टिंग एज अ जेनेटिक मटीरियल। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट सम ऑफ द हिस्टोरिकल एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ डीएनए, स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ डीएनए, in by what different components DNA is made up of and how these different components are arranged in DNA. So let's talk about the history first. See, DNA was first seen by Frederick Mischer in 1868 in pus cells, and there he named it as nucleon. Then one another scientist named Hartwig came and he said that this nucleon is the substance that is responsible for the transmission of characters. So he said that nucleon is responsible for transmission of characters, inheritable characters. That was the statement of Hartwig. And later on, in 1889, Altman changed the name from nucleon. He said nucleic acids, and he also discovered two type of nucleic acids. Nucleic acids, and we know these are DNA and RNA. That was done by Altman. And later on, after various years, in 1961, scientist named Kornberg synthesized in vitro DNA. In vitro DNA means in lab conditions DNA was synthesized using the nucleotides. Kornberg synthesized the DNA in lab. So these are some of the historical points of DNA. And where this DNA is present inside the cell? अगर हम DNA के presence की बात करते हैं, if I am talking about a prokaryotic cell, then in a prokaryotic cell, a circular DNA is present. And this circular DNA is present in the cytoplasm. This is the DNA and this is the cytoplasm of the cell. Because we know in prokaryotes there is no nuclear envelope. A true nucleus is absent. So the genetic material is present directly in the contact of the cytoplasm. This is how it is present in prokaryotes. While if we talk about eukaryotes, in a eukaryotic cell, a well-defined nucleus is present in the center of the cell. And inside this nucleus, linear DNA is present. Here, only single circular DNA is present. Let me write this. In prokaryotic cell, single circular DNA is present. While in eukaryotic cell, linear strands of DNA are present and they are multiple in number. Plus, they are not coming in direct contact with the cytoplasm. They are surrounded by a membrane, that is the nuclear membrane. This is how DNA is present. Now, other than nucleus, some of the other cell organelles are also having DNA, like mitochondria. In plants, plastid is there. So these are also having DNA, but their DNA is resembling with the prokaryotic DNA. That means single circular DNA is present in mitochondria and plastids, and this DNA is known as extra nuclear or extra chromosomal DNA. And this extra chromosomal DNA is resembling with the DNA of prokaryotes. This is where DNA is present. Now let's talk about the components of DNA. What DNA is made up of? See, DNA is a long polymer of nucleotides. Various nucleotides are combining together to form the DNA. So it is chain of polynucleotides. And it is the largest macromolecule. That is present. When we talk about the full form, it's deoxyribonucleic acid. And this deoxyribonucleic acid, the smallest unit of this deoxyribonucleic acid is a nucleotide. And a chain of nucleotides is going to form the DNA. Now this nucleotide, this is made up of three things. First one is a phosphate. This is how a phosphate is present. So the first is a phosphate is present in the nucleotide, and that is also giving acidic character to the DNA. This phosphate is responsible for providing acidic character to DNA. The second thing that is present in the DNA is deoxyribose sugar. A 5-carbon sugar is present, that is deoxyribose sugar. So let's see the structure of a 5-carbon sugar. This is the first carbon, the second carbon, third carbon, the fourth one and the fifth one. So this is a deoxyribose sugar that is present in the DNA. These are two components of nucleotide. The third one is nitrogenous base. And these three are joined together with the help of different bonds, and they are going to form a nucleotide. So let's talk about nitrogenous base. The nitrogenous bases, they are again broadly divided into bases depending upon how many ringed structures are there. It can be a purine, that is a double ring structure, or we can say 9-member structure, or usse hum kya bolte hain, purine. Now two purines are there, adenine and guanine. Let's see the structure of adenine and guanine. I said two rings, so this is the second ring that is present. This is how adenine is present. A double ring structure is there. And if we are going to count the members starting from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So this is how adenine is present. The second one is guanine. If we see the structure, there is a little bit difference. It is also a purine, that means again two rings are present. This is the second one. Now again, if I number it, so this is adenine and this is guanine. So two purine, two nitrogenous bases are double ring, and these are adenine and guanine. I am showing you here that this ninth carbon, this ninth nitrogen that is present over here, this is involved in the formation of glycosidic bond. We will talk about glycosidic bond later. So just remember that the ninth nitrogen of adenine and guanine are involved in the formation of glycosidic bond. So this is how purines are present. The second type are pyrimidines. And pyrimidines are single ring structure. Or six-membered structures. Again, the examples of pyrimidine are thymine, cytosine. These are the two pyrimidines that are present in the DNA. If we see the structure, so here what happens? A amino group is present over here, and the numbering is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. This is how numbering is done. This is the structure of O is here of thymine. So this is thymine, and there is a little bit difference in cytosine. Here H is present, that is going to form the bonding, and again numbering is going to come from here, starting from here. So these are single ring structure, six members are there, and here also the glycosidic bond is going to form between the first nitrogen. So these are the nitrogenous bases that are present in the DNA. If you see, there are four nitrogenous bases that are present in the DNA: adenine, guanine, thymine, and cytosine. Although there are just four nitrogenous bases, these nitrogenous bases are going to arrange themselves in different sequences. And because of the formation of different sequences, there is a huge variation, variety that can be seen in the DNA. And we know that in genetic material, variation is very important. So because of the assembly of these nitrogenous bases in different sequences, it is giving huge variations. Now let's talk about the bonding. We have talked about the components. These all polynucleotides, they are going to coil around the axis, and they are giving a double helical structure, and this double helical structure is right-handed. So the helix is formed, that is coiling around a common axis, and it is giving a double helical structure which is right-handed. So now we are going to talk about the bonding. First bonding is between. So let's see how bonds are formed. First we are seeing the backbone. The bond that is present in the backbone, and that is 3' to 5' phosphodiester bond. And this bond is functioning as a strong backbone that is making the DNA strand stable. So So how this bond is formed? This phosphodiester bond is going to form between phosphate and sugar. This is how the bond is formed. If I'll show you the backbone, then how the backbone of the DNA is present like this way. One phosphate bonded with, attached with sugar, another phosphate, sugar, phosphate, sugar. Same another strand also, here a sugar is there, phosphate, sugar, phosphate, sugar, phosphate, sugar. So this is making the backbone. And the bond that is present between this phosphate and sugar is the phosphodiester bond. 3' to 5' phosphodiester bond. So let's see how this bond is formed. So this bond is going to form between a sugar. I am showing a sugar molecule, another sugar molecule. And these two sugar molecules are there. This is the 3' carbon of this sugar molecule, and here the 5' carbon is present, and the bond is going to form between the 3' and 5' carbons of two adjacent sugars. So here the OH was there, O is present, phosphorus. This is the 3' to 5', this is the 5' carbon, 3', 5', phosphodiester bond. और दोनों ही जगह जब bond बना है, there is removal of water. Water क्या हुआ? Remove हो गया. So जितने भी bonds हम यहाँ discuss करते हैं, whether it is phosphodiester bond, we will talk about ग्लाइकोसिडिक बॉन्ड ऑल्सो. सारे ही बॉन्ड्स कैसे बनते हैं? कंडेंसेशन से बनते हैं, वॉटर रिमूव हो जाता है एंड बॉन्ड फॉर्मेशन इज देयर. सो यहाँ पर OH प्रेजेंट था, जहां से H रिमूव हो गया, यहाँ का फॉस्फेट के साथ जो OH था उन्होंने कंबाइन करके वॉटर बना लिया, दैट इज रिमूव्ड आउट. सेम थिंग ओवर हेयर ऑल्सो. और यहाँ पर एक बॉन्ड बन गया शुगर और फॉस्फेट के बीच में, जिसे हम बोलते हैं 3' 5' फॉस्फोडाइस्टर बॉन्ड. बिकॉज एक शुगर की 3' कार्बन इन्वॉल्व है और जो दूसरा शुगर है उसका 5' कार्बन इन्वॉल्व है. दैट्स व्हाई 3' टू 5' फॉस्फोडाइस्टर बॉन्ड. और ये बॉन्ड हमारे डीएनए की बैकबोन बनाता है. द अनदर बॉन्ड इज ग्लाइकोसिडिक बॉन्ड. जो दूसरा बॉन्ड बनता है दैट इज ग्लाइकोसिडिक बॉन्ड. और ये ग्लाइकोसिडिक बॉन्ड किनके बीच में बनता है? दिस ग्लाइकोसिडिक बॉन्ड इज फॉर्म्ड बिटवीन शुगर एंड नाइट्रोजिनस बेस. और नाइट्रोजिनस बेस में हमने देखा इट कैन बी अ प्यूरीन एंड इट कैन बी अ पिरिमिडीन. सो इफ प्यूरीन इज देयर, अगर शुगर के साथ एक प्यूरीन अटैच्ड है तो बॉन्डिंग किसके बीच में होगी? कार्बन वन ऑफ शुगर, फर्स्ट कार्बन ऑफ शुगर एंड 9th नाइट्रोजन, और वी कैन से N9 ऑफ अ प्यूरीन. दे आर गोइंग टू फॉर्म द ग्लाइकोसिडिक बॉन्ड. एंड इफ पिरिमिडीन इज देयर, देन द बॉन्डिंग विल बिटवीन फॉर अगेन फर्स्ट कार्बन ऑफ शुगर एंड फर्स्ट नाइट्रोजन ऑफ अ पिरिमिडीन. This is how glycosidic bond will take place between a nitrogenous base and sugar. Third one is hydrogen bond. And this hydrogen bond is going to form between nitrogenous bases. हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग हमेशा नाइट्रोजिनस बेसिस में बनता है. और ये हाइड्रोजन बॉन्ड कहाँ प्रेजेंट है? डीएनए के कोर में, हेलिक्स रीजन जो है वहां पर प्रेजेंट होता है. नाउ दिस हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग इज स्पेसिफिक, इट इज हाईली स्पेसिफिक. एंड हाउ दिस हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग टेक प्लेस? इट ऑलवेज टेक्स प्लेस बिटवीन वन प्यूरीन एंड वन pyrimidine. There will be no hydrogen bonding between one pyrimidine with another pyrimidine or between two purines. The hydrogen bonding always takes place between one purine and one pyrimidine. So the specific hydrogen bonding is A is going to form two hydrogen bonds with T, or it can be a reverse situation, and G is going to form three hydrogen bondings with C. So here one purine is there, one pyrimidine is there. This is the same situation, one purine is there and one pyrimidine is there. So bonding always takes place, hydrogen bond always takes place between a purine and a pyrimidine, not between two purines or not between two pyrimidines. We will discuss the reason behind this. So this is how hydrogen bonding is taking place. And because this hydrogen bonding is specific, so this hydrogen bonding is leading to complementary strands. इस स्पेसिफिक हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग की वजह से डीएनए के जो दो स्ट्रैंड्स हैं वो एक दूसरे के आइडेंटिकल नहीं होते हैं, दे आर कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री टू ईच अदर. और अगर हमें डीएनए की एक सीक्वेंस पता है, एक स्ट्रैंड पता है, वी आर गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट, वी कैन इजिली फाइंड आउट द सेकेंड स्ट्रैंड बिकॉज वी नो द स्पेसिफिक हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग दैट इज टेकिंग प्लेस. सो वी कैन इजिली फाइंड आउट द कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री स्ट्रैंड. सो दीज आर द थ्री बॉन्ड्स. और अगर इन तीनों बॉन्ड्स को मैं डीएनए स्ट्रैंड में रिप्रेजेंट करती हूं, हाउ दे आर गोइंग टू अपीयर, इफ वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस इन अ डीएनए स्ट्रैंड, सो लेट मी ड्रॉ अ स्ट्रैंड. दिस इज द बैकबोन. लाइक दिस वे. एंड इन बिटवीन हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग इज देयर. This is how they are present. If I represent the bonds, the bond that is present over here between this is a phosphodiester bond. That is the backbone. Now the bond that is present between the nitrogenous base and sugar, this is a sugar and this is a nitrogenous base. The bond that is present over here is a glycosidic bond, and the bond that is present between the nitrogenous bases in the core region, that is the hydrogen bond. So these are the different bonds that are present in the DNA, and all these bonds, they are responsible for the stabilization of the structure of DNA. And this DNA, the strands of DNA are also showing polarity. Means one strand is the 5 prime strand and another is the 3 prime strand. We will see how this polarity is achieved. But always remember, there is polarity and there is variation also in the DNA strands. Polarity can be explained simply by the thing that the DNA strands, both the DNA strands, they run anti-parallel to each other. The DNA strands are anti-parallel to each other. Anti-parallel, how they are anti-parallel? This is simply depending upon the orientation of sugar molecule. The sugar molecules that are present in the backbone, they are oriented differently. Means, if in one strand, this is the orientation of a sugar molecule, the first carbon, second, third, fourth and fifth. In the second strand, this is the orientation. First carbon, second, third, fourth and fifth. So I represent, if I represent the carbons, because that is important, playing important role. This is the 5 prime end that is present in this direction. And this is here the 5 prime end that is present this direction, and this is the 3 prime end. So you can see the difference. Here the 5 prime end is in upper direction and 3 prime in lower direction. While here the 3 prime is present in upper direction and 5 prime is present in lower direction. So because of this opposite orientation of sugar molecules, the two strands of DNA are running anti-parallel to each other, and because of this anti-parallel nature, we are getting the polarity. Here the 5 prime carbon of the sugar molecule will be free, so this will be a 5 prime end. Here the 3 prime OH will be free, it will be the 3 prime end. This is how polarity is achieved. You can easily show the bonding over here. Let me show one bonding. Another sugar molecule is present, the carbon of another sugar molecule, and the again 3 prime end. Same situation is here also. You can show the bonding. This is the CH2, O is present, O, and this O will be the, say this is the, this is the third, and this is the 5 prime. So this is how bonding is taking place between two strands, and they are giving them a anti-parallel nature. That's all for today. Next time we will discuss the Chargaff rule.